Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome to today's InfoPedia web conference titled Overview and Objective and Key Results. We're finishing some last minute preparations for our show and we'll be getting started in just a few minutes. So go ahead and sit back, relax, and we'll begin shortly. All right, ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome to today's InfoPedia web conference titled Overview and Objective and Key Results. We are broadcasting this web conference via Skype meeting broadcast and the audio can be heard through your PC speakers. Today's web conference has been recorded on behalf of the Microsoft Corporation. If you do not consent to being part of a recorded session, we ask that you please disconnect your browser at this time. Attendees may access the web conference recording via a link that will be delivered within 72 hours post-conference. You may ask a question at any time using the Q&A panel located either to the right of your screen or by scrolling down to just below the video pane. Our presenters are going to be responding to your questions throughout the presentation and again at the end of the presentation during a formal Q&A. And lastly, if you experience any technical difficulties during today's web conference, first try refreshing your web browser by pressing the F5 key. If that doesn't work, you'll want to go ahead and click on the support link at the top right corner of your browser. And with that, we are going to go ahead and get started. Presenting from Microsoft today, we have Nikolai, Senior PM Manager. Nikolai, the floor is all yours.
Thank you. Welcome to today's session, Envisioning Process and Objective Key Results Methodology Overview. So for my name is Nikolai. I'm Senior PM Manager and I work at Skype for Business Customer Experience and Deployment Team. My team contributes in SOF and we also run deployments using Skype Operational Framework at customers worldwide. As usual, training disclaimer, especially if you watch this broadcast recordings. Skype Operational Framework is a living framework. We keep iterating on it based on experience we receive from customers and partners. So please check the latest version of the video on Skype Operational Framework, operations framework/academy. This is V1 version of the training. This is the third training in our learning cycle. On Monday, we introduced Skype Operational Framework, what it is, why we created it, what principles are in Skype Operational Framework. Yesterday, we overviewed Get Deployed Cloud PBX and PSTN Conferencing offer. We understood what are key components of the offer, what tools, assets we have. We reviewed project flow, we reviewed trainings. Today we will be concentrating on the first phase of this offer, which is envisioning. And our goal today is to understand envisioning process and its role in overall offer, review assets and methodology, understand objective key results approach to project management, which we are using as part of the offer, review key success indicators, and review in details two sessions as a part of Envisioning, which a part of Envisioning is kickoff and wrap-up sessions. Let's start from Envisioning process overview and understand what components do we have in this process. So before we will jump to the components, let's think why we need Envisioning process. To me, Envisioning process is one of the key element of overall project deploy of overall project. If you done so, for example, we on Envisioning process we define high level architecture. We define key success indicators, how we will be measuring the success of the deployment. We create execution plan. We collect information on objectives from project executives. We capture the information about technical environment. And if you make the, if some mistakes made during the Envisioning process and we start deploying our own architecture or we don't address business use cases for the company, then your deployment can result in failure, which is quite costly for customers and partners. So therefore, we think that Envisioning process is the key component and it serves as input for all other activities throughout the project. Let's review the flow. On the slide, you can see recommended flow, which we run with customers on our own or our partners run. Most of the activities starting from Envisioning kickoff until Envisioning kickoff call until the presentation vision and scope, and we will go into workflow in a couple minutes. We recommend conducting on-site in 2 to 3 days workshop. Before you go on-site, the first activities that you need to do is agree on the program itself. This is the first call, it can be remote. Agree on the program, agree on running the offer within your company or at customer if you're a partner. Then analyze next two activities, analyze current environment. If customer has users in Skype for Business online already, then you can set up call quality dashboard and get the information about current call quality and usage using this tool. And as we discussed yesterday, Skype, the Get Deployed offer contains guidance how to configure, for example, dashboard and how to get this information. Or if customer is on premises, then you can run customer has Skype for Business or link on premises. Then you can run scripts to capture the same information, and Skype operational framework provides you with those scripts. They can be downloaded on our site. The next is discovery questionnaire. So you share the discovery questionnaire with the stakeholders, and we will talk about the stakeholders and their roles and capture information such as technical environment, adoption processes and procedures, network, basic information about network, information about stakeholders. And the idea is to get good chunk of data before you start planning and agree with your key stakeholders on deliverables and timeline when you deploy Cloud PBX. So once you have the data from those three activities, then, as I said, we recommend setting a series of on-site workshops. The first one is Envisioning kickoff, where we recommend, highly recommend participation of project executive, and we will talk about roles just in 1 minute. The goal of this Envisioning workshop, so imagine you came to the customer, you have some information about environment, you have information about their usage. And the goal of Envisioning Kickoff is to get understanding from executives what are objectives of deploying cloud PBX. Is it reducing the cost? Is it increasing the efficiency of your end users? And when executive sponsors want to deploy cloud PBX? Is it 1 month? Is it 2 months? Is it 3 months? Based on the customer size, the schedule can be different. So once you get these objectives, and we will talk in details about this, once you get the objectives from customer executives, you go and plan the solution to understand how achievable this objective given within the timeline which executives see. So you start from business uses for business use cases workshop, and again, each and every activity listed on the side on this slide has a corresponding collateral and material which can be downloaded from our site. So you run business use cases workshop where you understand current business processes of customer and understand how Skype can be incorporated in these business processes. You also understand end user profiles, how many users are remote, how many users are working from office mostly. It will significantly influence design in the future, design the solution itself, design of peripheral devices that we need to provide to users. So the next activity, so you have objectives from executives, you have understanding of how end users work, what are the types of end users. The next one is capture more information about network. You run network readiness kickoff meeting where you share the questionnaire per site and agree on capturing this data. So likely your network team, if it's a big customer, they won't be able to answer all questions right away. If it's a relatively medium or small company, you probably will have this network questionnaire completed. And this will serve as an input for your architecture. The next one is the review discovery questionnaire, which you collected before the visit with appropriate stakeholders, and clarify any questions that might be left. On this step, you have objectives, you have desired timeline, you understand use cases, you understand your end users, you have high-level understanding of network, you have understanding of technical environment. So based on all this information, you can create high-level architecture. So the next workshop, it's actually 4 to 8 hours whiteboarding activity, I would say. We do have a PowerPoint deck, which guide you through the process, and the session, how to deliver this will be provided to you as a part of this learning webinars. But you take this all this information and actually create high-level architecture. What option of cloud PBX with Microsoft PSTN calling, with your own SIP trunk via cloud connector or full pool per site you will deploy? What does PSTN conferencing story looks like? What does notification story looks like? How you will manage users? What licenses do you need to deploy this solution? Everything is covered in this high-level architecture session, and we provide the template. Upon this step, you have business use cases, you have high-level architecture defined per each and every site. The next activity is to plan adoption of the solution. And we have 3 adoption workshops, which can be run at the same time. The first adoption workshop is to agree on adoption strategy and key stakeholders. As part of Get Deployed offer, we do provide you adoption strategy based on best practices, which we collected during the deployments or via our partners. And the goal of the first workshop is to agree on proposed adoption strategy, agree on key stakeholders who will be preparing launch event, who will be doing training materials, for example, who will be planning adoption per site. So once you agree on approach, high level, and on key stakeholders, then you go and do detailed planning of success plan workshop per site. And the next adoption activity is choosing the right device. Remember, we had the information from end users about end users from business use case workshop. So we do understand at this moment which users are remote, which users are local, how many attendants they have, how many users are working purely from office. We present the deck. We have a deck with describing each and every peripheral, pros and cons. And based on the information we received earlier in this deck, you just map users to appropriate devices which will fit their needs. So at this moment, we have architecture, we have business use cases, we understand our adoption strategy, we understand network, we understand environment overall. So the next step would be, again, it's whiteboarding activity. We do provide template for this. The next activity is to collect everything together and create schedule. Who is doing what we call tracy, who is responsible, who is accountable, who is consulted, who is informed for each site. Define key success indicators. We will talk about them a little bit later. Define all stakeholders. By the end of execution planning workshop, you will have high level schedule based on the input you've got from executive stakeholders. You will have high level schedule when and how you will deploy cloud PBX for the company. If it's small, medium business, then deployment can be done in 90 days or less. If it's a big business, then deployment can be done in a year or even two based on the current environment. But the execution planning workshop actually answers the question of executives if objective deployment of cloud PBX can be achieved in desired timeline. So once you have this, you create vision and scope document and vision and scope presentation, and again go to project executives and presenting what you've planned. So actually you started on envisioning kickoff, you get the objectives, then you've done planning, and you go and present what you've planned with project team and get the agreement from the executives on the project. As you saw, there are series of workshop, technical, non-technical workshop, execution planning. So we so that someone who is delivering those workshops should have a broad skill set. And there are some prerequisites for envisioning phase. So someone who will be delivering and orchestrating should understand Skype operational framework itself, should familiarize himself or herself with assets and methodology included in Cloud PBX and PSC and calling Get Deployed offer. Have commitment from right stakeholders, and we will talk about stakeholders, and have technical expertise in Skype for Business Online and surrounding technologies. By surrounding technologies, I mean Exchange, for example, authentication mechanism, and of course, networking. You can learn most of these skills during this series of webinars. Let's talk a little bit about key players in envisioning. On the slide, there are three key roles listed. And I just want to highlight the fact that depends on customer. Some roles can be combined and can be, it can be just one person acting as, let's say, project executive, sponsor, project lead. And some customers, those are different people. But for the successful deployment, you need to identify those roles, regardless if one person plays two or three roles, or if it's separate persons. So let's review the key roles that you need to for the Get Deployed offer and Envision in particular. On the right, I listed the activities and workshop where we expect those roles participate to during the Envisioning activity. Of course, there are some other activities like deployment, like adoption, when you switch to deliver phase, where their participation also required, but for this training we will talk only about Envisioning activities. So project executive sponsor, one of the most important role in the project, and he or she has ultimate authority and accountability for the project from customer side. He or she sponsors communications. He or she resolves the issues that requires executive power. He or she responsible for making strategic decision, serves as a project sponsor for the overall program and leads quarterly business reviews. And we will talk about quarterly business reviews a little bit later. So actually from that person, we are getting strategic objectives or during Envision kickoff and present the results during Envision wrap-up. Project lead manages and leads all project team, coordinates work of partners if partners are involved, accountable for creating and managing project plans, resolves cross-functional issues, escalates issues if he or she cannot solve them, escalates to project executive sponsors. Leads monthly business reviews and incorporates or contributes to quarterly business reviews. So that person should participate in program presentation, the first, very first activity. Of course, kickoff where we collect or capture information about strategic objectives, business use cases workshop to provide the input on end user profiles, network readiness kickoff to coordinate collection of the data and provide input. Architecture workshop for sure, to provide input on architecture. Execution planning workshop, input on quarterly plans, key success indicators, governance plan, and we will talk in details about quarterly plans, KSI, in just a minute. Creating and presenting vision and scope to project team. If you think, so there are two possible options. You can deploy as customer on your own or deploy with the help of partner. If you think about those roles, the model of people who will be acting on those roles, they will be different. So if it's, let's say, customer only deployment, all roles from customer. If it's customer plus partner, some roles, project executive sponsor, definitely from the customer. Project lead can be either from customer or partner, or it can be combined. So you can have project lead at customer side and at partner side. So the next role is collaboration lead architect. So this person actually is responsible overall for collaboration design at the collaboration design and operation of the solution. He or she also contributes to monthly, quarterly business review. And of course, this person requires to be on Envision kickoff, business use cases to provide input and listen what are typical business use cases if he or she doesn't know it. Network readiness kickoff. The biggest role this person plays in architecture workshop and contributes in defining architecture per site or per company. Of course, execution planning workshop and creating presenting vision and scope to project team. So those three key roles that should be defined very early at early stages of your project. The other roles that we have, I will go briefly over them. So we have consultants, so someone who will be responsible for configuring services on site, And we expect those person participate in architecture workshop, execution planning workshop, and of course, contributing, creating, presenting vision and scope. Project manager, so someone who keeps us on track during the deployment and maintains project plans. We expect this person to be on Envision kickoff, network readiness kickoff, to coordinate efforts, especially in a situation where customer has many sites. So we need someone who will be managing collecting of the activity and collection of the data and tracking this. Execution planning workshop, this is the project manager, is the key person in execution planning workshop as we are working on schedule there. And contributing, of course, on creating and presenting vision and scope to project team. Change management adoption specialist provides input. So the role of this person is to be responsible and accountable for adoption at the company. And of course, all adoption workshops, it's this person is key person in all adoption workshop and participates in business use cases, Envision kickoff, and presentation of vision and scope. Network lead, someone who will be helping us to open ports, configure QoS. Of course, this person should participate in network readiness kickoff and key player and network readiness kickoff and architecture workshop. We also expect him or her participating in Envision kickoff and execution planning workshop to provide input on, for example, when ports will be opened. And some other roles as telephony lead, desktop lead, security lead, support help desk lead. Those people should participate in, of course, architecture workshops, and they might participate in some other activities. So for example, telephony lead, network leadness kickoff. All of them, we recommend inviting all of them on presenting the vision and scope document to project team. And business unit representatives, they are participating in business use cases workshop to provide input on how they use the solution. So once you define key stakeholders and agreed on the plan, you are ready to move to envisioning. And as I said, each and every activity which we listed on the slide before has corresponding set of documentation, which can be downloaded on skypeoperationsframework.com. So we have activity description, we have, so what I'm describing now, we actually have the version, simplified version, a little bit shorter version as a document, activity description, envisioning workshop activity description. We have also activity description, how to run network readiness. Remember, we have one network readiness call, which are run as part of envisioning activities. We have delivery guidance. So for example, how to run script, which I mentioned, which is the second activity for customers who have on-premises deployment. How to run network readiness. We also have workshops, so PowerPoint for each and every workshop, which were listed on previous slides. Discovery, envisioning kickoff, network readiness kickoff, business use case workshop, wrap-up workshop, architecture workshop, adoption workshops, different adoption workshops, and execution planning workshops. We also provide you questionnaires, discovery questionnaire, network readiness questionnaire, tools such as scripts and templates, such as Word document, which you can share to executives upon completion of Envision activities. So as I said, documents can be downloaded on Skype Operations Framework. Documents with prefix Envision on the right, there is a prefix for each and every document. With Envision and Adopt, you can download from Get Started Plan, Envision the solution. Documents with prefix Assess, Get Started Plan, Determine Network Readiness. One common tool and assets have a life cycle. So we keep iterating on them, and please, before each and every delivery, check if newer version is available. So with that knowledge, so we reviewed the envisioning process flow. We understood What workshops are included? We understood key players and where they should participate. Let's switch to review of two workshops. One is kickoff call and one is wrap-up call. Other activities will be covered in other sessions which are going throughout this and next weeks. So let's talk about Envisioning kickoff session. As I said, the goal of this session is to get the input from your customer executive on objective, what they want to deploy and why, what are key factors and by when. So we highly recommend doing it on site and complete discovery before this call so you better understand customer environment. So goals, as I said, identify objectives, understand, agree on project management model and flow, and we talk about this, identify potential constraints because its executive usually knows better than others what are potential events can be that can affect project flow, merge acquisition, for example, or reorganization. And this workshops is a basis, as I said, for all other activities. At minimum, as we discussed, project executive sponsor, project lead, and project manager should be presented on this workshop. Ideally, we recommend to invite everyone from the project team, not only those three roles, but those three roles are key roles in this Envisioning workshop. We usually run it in one hour, 30 minutes. Our best practice is to deliver it on site and in an environment where stakeholders are not disrupted. If you are a partner, let's say, and you have office, invite them to your office so people not distracted. If you're doing it on your own and you are a customer, schedule offsite somewhere. After all, and as I said, this first workshop provides input, then team goes to planning cycle for 2 to 3 days and present the results to the same audience. So it's very, very important to get it right. And kickoff materials, as I said, they can be downloaded from Skype operational framework, get started and envision the solution. So approximate agenda. So you do introduction, then you give the floor to executives. So give them floor to talk about why they choose Skype for Business. Likely they already made this decision if you are on this kickoff meeting. It's not a selling meeting, right? It's more understanding. So what are key drivers behind the solution? Why they decided to deploy Skype for Business? What other solutions they reviewed? What are timelines? What are key pain points they try to solve with this solution? So once you get this, and we will talk about this a little bit more, once you get this, you present methodology and success indicators, get the high-level agreement from executives, yes, we are okay going with this methodology, identify three key project stakeholders, which is executive sponsor, you log them, ideally you should have them before this workshop, which is project executive sponsor, project lead, and project manager, and define next step, next sessions. So we talked a lot about objective and key results. Let's review this. The objective and key results methodology, which we included in get Cloud PBX and PSTN calling, get deployed, and review why we recommend using this methodology for running your projects. So objective and key results project delivery methodology was initially created by Intel and was adopted by many, many companies such as Microsoft, Google, Twitter, Facebook, you name it. And the goal, what we're trying to achieve with introducing this methodology is actually we are bringing agile approach to deployment and planning for Skype for Business Online. This framework allows us iterate as we go and learn the environment. So imagine you just came to the customer and you started deploying. You have no idea how long security procedures per site will take. You have no idea how long adoption of users will take. So in order to iterate on this, and in order to learn and iterate and deliver your project in time, we don't recommend you setting the huge goal at the beginning. We do recommend setting the goal, but we don't recommend doing like detailed planning for 1 or 2 years upfront. Of course, if you have small customer, that doesn't apply and you can done it like in 1 or 2 months. But if you're a huge customer, so we recommend you get the vision. So why you deploy Skype for Business, which is the first one, increase productivity via maximizing O365 E5 investments, for example. Then you split it into objectives. This is what we are getting from executives. So let's say objective one, we are talking about overall E5 investments. Deploy cloud PBX with enterprise voice for 4,000 employees worldwide by December 2017. And objective two, utilize Skype for Business broadcast for all meetings which are bigger than 2,500 users. So you can prioritize on this level because you have limited resources, which objective has higher priority, which objective has lower priority. So this is once you define this objective with executives, then you go and create quarterly plan. And on this example, we have quarter one, we deploy only 500 users. And for quarter one, we run all activities. So we do planning, for example, envision, access, design, prepare per site. We do deliver, deploy, enable, adopt, enhance again per site. We do operate, run, monitor, support, and report again per site. The second quarter, as you might see on this example, and this example from real custom, it's deploy cloud PBX for 1,000 users. And the reason we increased is that we assume that based on the results of first quarter, we will get the learnings. How long security procedures take? How long port opening procedures take? How long quality of service configuration takes? So you can increase velocity of your project. And by the end of that project, you can even deliver more users. There is also one more option of potential is that you learn that you can deliver faster than you planned initially. So then you can change the goal for the first quarter as you execute. So objective key results, the key message here that you define the long-term objective and do quarterly planning. And one of the additional aspect here is what I called is iterate on the learnings. So we also recommend you to run monthly and quarterly review where you compare what you planned with the real situation. So let's say we have quarter plan represented here for 500 users. So you do envisioning in first month, you do network assessment in first month, you do design in month one and month two, you do preparation month one and month two, and you start deployment in month two for 500 users. That can be different sites. Then you do enable, launch event, trainings, run, monitor, support. Let's say you learned that preparation includes opening ports, configuring QoS, and you learned that preparation phase actually cannot be started by at least until middle of month two. And reasons can be different. Appropriate stakeholders on vacation. It requires review by some other people. So you can just move everything and you move preparation from month one, starting month one to middle of month two. And all other activities, because deployment is dependent on preparation, will also be moved. But as you have monthly reviews with appropriate stakeholders, you can iterate. You can say, okay, we will not do preparation of this site in month one. We can take other site. We will start other preparation for other sites. Or you can say, we are slightly delaying the project and likely we will be over the schedule. But it's always transparent. So it's always communicated to appropriate stakeholders, and it helps you to be on track and be in sync throughout all project team. And on quarterly business review, where we recommend participation of executives, you are presenting what you've done in the quarter, how you changed your plan, and do we need to make any adjustments in your high-level quarter goals that you defined. So we highly recommend you to bring transparency in the project to make sure that everyone in sync apply objective key results methodology with monthly and quarterly review. And one more very important factor that you need, and again, you need to present this to executive sponsors and make sure that executive sponsors are okay with this methodology and okay with proposed approach. Usually they are, I haven't seen any objections or resistance to this. And one more key element that we recommend you to review with executives during the kickoff call is actually how we will measure the success. Okay, we will deploy the cloud PBX in first quarter for 500 users. So what? So what if users don't use the solution? What if their call quality is bad? You can deploy the solution, no one uses it, this failure. Therefore, we highly recommend to make sure that you agree with your executive sponsor on how you will be measuring the success. You don't need to set those key success indicators on this call. They will be finalized on execution planning workshop. But let's review, but you need to present them. Present, and Skype operational framework provides you example of key success indicators. Let's look at them and agree that yes, this is the right way to measure success of the deployment. Here is this KCI starting set, which we recommend to measure in each and every deployment. Let's talk a little bit about this. So we should measure, as I said, if we deploy and no one uses it, or if we deploy and users complain about the solution, so it's failure. How we can measure this? So let's say usage and adoption. You can send survey to end users with some questions. For example, question number one. The quality of the conversation is equal or better than the previous solution. You send it to the users, and if more than 80% of users agree or strongly agree with this is success. If not, then you can read the comments, you can understand. So for example, some customer, we figured out that the peripherals which we provided to them, they were, users didn't like them. And that's why they said, no, my experience is bad. Worse than previous solution. We changed the peripherals and we've got absolutely different picture. Now user says, oh, that's good. This is great solution. We recommend measuring those, this indicator, particular indicator, every after enablement and quarterly. You can target users. It's not the same users should receive the survey, but you can pick, for example, user per quarter, and one user can be surveyed, for example, once a year or twice a year. The second question, again, those are starting sets. This is examples that we are using in our deployment. You can add your own or you can change them. The second question, Skype for Business made communication process easier. Again, survey, and 80% of users should agree or strongly agree. If we migrated from some third-party PBX and we made a communication process worse or more difficult, again, that doesn't make sense. So we need to learn and iterate. From our experience, most of those questions, of course, 80% plus, as we are deploying very good solutions, Skype for Business Online. You can also measure real usage using Office 365 report, so-called quality dashboard. And we do recommend to measure it on daily or monthly basis based on the customer size and present on operational and quarterly business review. And by the way, all these results should be discussed on monthly and quarterly business reviews. So we said we will learn and iterate. percentage of pool calls or conferences should be less than 5%. You can use call quality dashboard to measure this. I know how to get technical support served on users after enablement and after incidents. Your users should understand how to get it. I'm satisfied with quality of technical support. Again, to measure the level of satisfaction, understand if you need to adjust your operational procedures. And one financial key success indicators, which we are measuring with all our customers, is actually reduction of legacy conference minutes, or in some customers, we are measuring ROI, return of investments. So what we've planned initially, return of investments, how we executing against this. Are we really saving money, or are there some learnings we need to incorporate in the solution? So methodology, objectives, methodology, key success indicators, something that you need to communicate to executive sponsors and get their approvals. One more thing that you need to discuss on this meeting is identify key risk. New data centers, reorg, office relocation, measure acquisition, network redesign, based on executive input. So once you defined targets, so you have now objective key results, you agreed on agile methodology, you agreed how you will be measuring the success, you agreed on monthly and quarterly operational review and iteration process. You should have high level documented next steps, right? So, and objectives. So, for example, enable 4 or 10K for cloud PBX worldwide before end of 2017. Create repeatable. Those are real examples. Examples of real objectives. Create repeatable standard design and deployment methodology that will be proven in several sites. We shall all to build communication infrastructure for new offices within 5 days from request to delivery by the end of 2016. So you define it objectives, you define the stakeholders, you agreed on execution framework, you agreed on high-level measuring key success indicators. So the next step would be to run workshops, as we discussed, that will answer. So we've got what, and now we need to answer how we will get to this objective. So the next workshops, as we discussed, they will answer how. Business use case, network readiness, architecture, adoption, execution planning, and then presenting back to executives. And one more, I will not cover during this session what is in between. I'm covering how to collect the objectives and input for planning, and how to deliver a wrap-up workshop. Other activities covered in other sessions, which are starting tomorrow. So once you've done this, once imagine that you collected objectives, you completed all planning, and then you need to present the planning to your executives. We have envisioned wrap-up session. Again, we do recommend to deliver it on site. You need to complete all planning activities. You need to document them, and then present to your executives and get high-level approval. Yes, thank you for doing this. Yes, I approve, and this is our vision. And goal, as I said, approve the design, approve governance plan, approve key success indicator, approve schedule. And again, the key players in this activity are executive sponsor, project lead, and project manager. We highly encourage to have all project team on this meeting. And again, best practice to deliver it on site during the visit. And you also will have vision and scope document, which can serve as a basis for statement of work if you are a partner who is deploying. And again, just to recap, so we are setting We are setting goals on vision kickoff call. We are doing planning 2 to 3 days, and we are presenting the results and vision and scope session where we have, and we have templates for this. Wrap up materials can be downloaded on Skype operational framework in Envision the Solution section. With that, I just want to recap. So thank you for attending this session. We will get to the questions soon. I just want to recap what we learned today. So we reviewed envisioning process. We reviewed different activities in their role in overall cloud PBX and PSTN calling a deployed offer. We understand assets, and we reviewed methodology, objective key results with key success indicators. We reviewed in details kickoff and wrap-up sessions. The next session, so to complete your journey, so we now completed 3 sessions, which is Skype operational framework overview, get deployed offer overview, overview of envisioning process and objective key results methodology. The next session is envisioning discovery process overview, business use cases, high level architecture workshop, which we'll be delivering in upcoming days. And in upcoming weeks, you will have other sessions which will cover deliver and operate phases of the offer. I will give you just a second to read. So we would really appreciate your feedback, and we would like to hear from you your thoughts on the framework and offer itself. And of course, we really would like to hear your feedback on real deployment. So what you learned, what works, what didn't work. So please provide the feedback. And with that, let me go to Q&A session and review if we have any unanswered questions. So I don't see any unread or unanswered questions. I see only thank you. Thank you. So yeah, please let us know, and thank you. Thank you for your comment. Please let us know in writing what do you think about the session. So other questions what I see are answered. So what is PBX? It's private branch exchange. So it's actually your, yeah. No, I don't see any unanswered questions. So recording of the end, I'm here for a couple more minutes until 8 more minutes. Do I need to, so the question is, do I need to register for every single sessions? Yes. So for now, please, you need to go and register for every single session. We hear this feedback that it would be, it will make more sense to register at once, and we are working on this. But for now, please register for every session. We are working on redesigning the site. So any other unanswered questions? And recording will be available 3 days after the session.
There is
a question where you can find the recording. So this recording Skype operations framework /academy. So if you go to Skype operations framework, there is a link on academy.
All right, thanks, Nikolai. While we wait for any last lingering questions to come in, I just wanted to mention to the audience, if you've not already found it, I'd like to bring your attention to the link on the upper right-hand side of the viewing window that says, please take a short survey. That's a link to a short survey for this web conference, and we ask that you please take a moment before logging out to access it. We hope that you found today's information helpful, and if you enjoyed today's web conference or have feedback on how we can provide you with a better event, this is your chance to let us know. The survey scores are on a scale from 1 to 5, with 5 being the highest score possible. And as a reminder, if you'd like to ask a question, just simply type it into the white text box in the Q&A panel located either to the right of the video player or by scrolling down, and it'll appear under the video player. While we wait for those to come back in, I'm going to go ahead and turn it back over to Nikolai to see if he has any final thoughts before we wrap up.
Thank you, and I keep monitoring Q&A, so please, if you have any questions, ask them, and looking forward to seeing you on next sessions.
All right, and with that, we're going to go ahead and conclude today's web conference. Thank you, Nikolai. I'd like to extend a big thank you to our presenter, Nikolai, of course, and thank you, audience, for logging in and joining us today. We are going to have the recording available for you via a link that will be delivered by email within 72 hours post-conference. You may now disconnect from the web conference.